尽管亚洲金融中心开始出现版图变化，香港百万富豪减少4%，但艺术相关机构却开始在香港快速生根发芽。从2021年到2023年，就成长了27%。全球两大拍卖龙头在香港持续展开拍卖活动，艺术商机在香港越炒越热，尤其是新世代买家更是不断的增加。
The buyers are increasingly younger. What we've seen actually in 2023, Gen X is the most important buy base. Actually, over $1 million, they dominate the market, and that's for the first time.And now we see, of course, millennials taking on contemporary art, and the market now, over 50% of our buys in contemporary art are millennials.Our social media presence is very strong now.
香港几家拍卖行更是占了地利之便，吸引大量的中国大陆买家的眼光。
Chinese art and ancient Chinese art is really at the genesis of Sotheby's Hong Kong, and the value of these historical works of art has really gone up since the Chinese entered this market dramatically 25 years ago. I think could fetch $20 million in today's market. This is really an object of the greatest historical importance.
大量的中国大陆买家也因此开始发现香港不少新锐艺术家的作品，也渐渐走进他们的视野当中。香港多媒体艺术家 Mark Tu 就是新生代艺术家当中相当独特的观念艺术家。
In 2017, I make an inflatable snow globe called You Better Watch Out. So inside there are QR codes floating around. So when the audience come in, and then they will scan the QR code.After they scan it, it will bring you to the video. Actually, the video is the CCTV behind you. So you are not just watching the snow globe, you are also being inside the snow globe being watched.
Mac Tu 虽然擅长多媒体艺术，但他本身不作画，而是透过委托来利用不同的视角呈现艺术作品。像是他标志性的作品《美好家园》，就是请淘宝上不知名的画家分开绘画，组合在一起窥探现实与虚拟世界的裂缝。
It's basically pretty random because I also want the randomness in it. Because the concept of it is, I want to say thatThe ideal version of home, when it is translated in the real world, is basically random. It's basically out of control.
在他特别为2024年巴塞尔艺术展香港展会而创作的装置作品，利用《美好家园》这个作品进一步探讨复制、演化还有模拟的概念。
There is a quote I particularly like from the book Still Like an Artist. Is that originality is an undetected plagiarism, which means that nothing is original. But I think maybe true because when you need to make something new, you got to have some reference, right?
巴塞尔艺术展展现亚洲地区的多元创作，成为新晋艺术家的必争之地。全世界的买家都会不辞千里来到香港。
As an art fair, being in the center of the art ecosystem, we are able to bring together these different parts of the ecosystem together onto our platform. At the same time, Hong Kong has always been, convenient for art businesses. We've seen collectors, visitors, art lovers, coming from US, Australia, Switzerland, pretty much all over the world.
要让这些新生代的艺术家在艺术展当中发挥各种天马行空，画廊的支持也是背后重要的推手。
We work with a very small group of artists, and one of the reasons for that is so that each of them can get our time and attention. A lot of the artists that we represent are still very young, and so they are still in their exploration stage. And so it's always helpful to have a sounding board, someone they can talk to, and that's often our role. As a gallery, we actually try not to prioritize the market. We try to help the artists develop their own unique practices, their own unique styles. It's important not to compromise to the demand of the market.
业者尤其看好数位艺术，尽管在 AI 技术不断更新的时代，业者认为数位艺术的发展依旧获得市场青睐。香港作为亚洲艺术市场的重要枢纽，在这股数位艺术浪潮当中，将继续扮演着关键角色。体育新闻综合报道
，TVBS 大运动家、运动迷一起竞技的殿堂，马上下载，跟中华队一起 all in。